Are you one of the millions of Apple Photos users that use Apple Photos to organize and save and store all of your pictures and videos? But when it comes time to share those pictures and videos with your friends and family, you don't really know the best way to do it? I understand. It can be complicated and there's lots of options on how to share photos and videos. My name is Dylan Stewart. They call me the MacWhisperer, and in this video, I'm gonna walk you through the best ways to do it. In this video, which is part three of my ongoing series about how to get organized with Apple Photos, I'm going to show you the best ways to share your pictures. Because as we all know, sharing is caring. First off, we're going to talk about how to share photos and videos outside of the Photos app. Then we're going to talk about how to use the Photo app itself to text, to email, and even to airdrop those pictures to anyone you want super, super easily. Then we're going to talk about shared albums. Shared albums are amazing and valuable. And then I'm going to drop the most powerful brand new tool for sharing, which is called a shared photo library. So make sure you stick around for that one because it is a super powerful tool. Now that we know where we're going, let's hop on over to the computer and get started. The first thing we want to talk about is how to send photos through email. And you're in the middle of an email and you think to yourself, hey, I'd like to add a photo to this. Your instinct is probably going to be to come up here and click on the paperclip, which allows you to attach things. Don't do that. The attachment button is fine and all, but it's far from the best way to do things, especially photos. The best way to do photos is to come over here to the photo browser, click on it, and choose photos. A separate window will pop up that will give you instant access to your photo library. And right from here, you can find your favorites or specific people that you've tagged or your shared albums or your standard albums, including all of the media types for things like videos or portraits. You can just drag it right over into the email, or you can select a number of things and drag all of them over to the email together, and they'll just jump right into that message, making it easy for you to type up your message, get that photo together, and just click send. When you're sending photos in an email, you have to be a little conscious of how many photos you're sending and what quality they're in. Emails have a maximum file size, and if you send more than that file size, it's not gonna go out. So it's always a good idea to keep it under 10 megabytes, if at all possible. Right over here on the left side, you can see what your message size is. Right at the moment, I'm at almost 15, so I might wanna scale this back a little bit. And you might say, no problem, Dylan, just delete a couple of photos and send the photos in multiple emails. Don't do that. That's annoying and frustrating. What you wanna do is come over to the right side where you see the image size and take it off of actual size. You can easily drop it down to medium, which makes the pictures a much more manageable size to begin with. They're still really good quality, but it reduces our email size down to 600 kilobytes, which is less than 1 megabyte. And these pictures are gonna look great. By bringing the image size down to medium, or in some cases, even all the way down to small, you can send 25 pictures in one message without any headache whatsoever and easily keep it under that 10 megabyte limit. So that's how you do it through email. Now let's talk about how to do it through text messaging. Whenever you're sending a text message out, when you're in the message itself, down at the bottom, you can click on this little clump of apps here. This will open up and give you the option of a Photos browser. When you click on that, it's going to open up the Photos browser right here. And it gives you amazing tools because you can easily come in here and search for a specific place, like Disneyland, and then add additional criteria, like I also would like pictures of my son and pictures of me. Now in just a few moments, I've grabbed exactly what I'm looking for, pictures of my son and pictures of myself at Disneyland. Now all I have to do is find the pictures I want and click on them. They will get added directly to the text message. And when I'm ready, click the return button on my keyboard and those photos will go directly to the recipient. And that's how you send photos through the Messages app. Now let's talk about sharing photos through a browser. Sometimes you're going to be on a website and you're going to want to add pictures directly from your browser. In some cases, you can drag them right over from your photo library or you can save them to your desktop. But it's also very easy to access your photos library right from here. So if I was in Facebook and I go to Photos and Video and I click Add Photos, it's going to open up a Finder window. The same thing happens in Instagram and other apps. When you see this Finder window, I want you to look at the left sidebar all the way down at the bottom. There's a section here called Media, and right here are your photos. Clicking on that will bring up your entire photo library. From here, you can easily click on any images you want, and then press the Upload button, and it will add them right into the website easily and simply. And this will work with almost any browser and almost any web page. So those are some of the best ways to send photos and videos from apps that aren't the Photos app. Now let's talk about how to do it directly through the Photos app. The Apple Photos app is an amazing tool with all sorts of built-in functionality that makes it super simple to do things like sharing. The first step that you want to always do when you're sharing out your images is you want to pick the images first. There are three different ways to easily select multiple items. The first one is when the items are together in a row. For that, click on the first one, hold your shift button down, and click on the last one, and it will connect the dots between those two selections. The other way is when the pictures are kind of scattered around a little bit, which is way more common. Click on the first picture, and then hold the Command button down on your keyboard and click on each additional picture as you go. The third way is called the lasso. The way to use the lasso is to place your cursor above and to the left of whatever your pictures are that you want to select. Then you're going to click your mouse down and drag diagonally. Anything that falls inside of that lasso will immediately be selected, enabling you to very quickly grab a handful of photos that are clumped together so that you can share them all at once. And now we're ready to share them. The share button is right here and it's super powerful. When you click share, your options show up down here. You'll also see the options of people you've text messaged recently show up at the top. I'm gonna come down here and choose email first. When I click that, it's gonna automatically open up a new email message with those attachments right there. It's going to also stick to whatever size I last used. So because we had it set to small before, it's set to small again. I can up that to medium really easily and then go ahead and address it and send it out. You can also click the share button and go directly into text messages. This is going to bring up a window that makes it easy for you to send to one or more people. Remember, if you're sending to Android users, it'll show up in green, which tells you that you can't send that many pictures at once. But for Mac users, you can send almost as many as you want in one fell swoop, click the send button, and they're all gonna go out. You can also use the plus button here to add any additional recipients so that you can create a group very quickly. And now let's talk about the best way to share a large number of photos quickly. We're going to select a big bunch of them here, and I'm going to come back up to the share icon, and I'm going to choose Airdrop. Airdrop is a super powerful tool that allows you to send anything from any Apple device to any other Apple device. In fact, you can send hundreds and hundreds of photos via Airdrop in moments, which you can't do via email or text. I'm gonna click on Airdrop here, and it's gonna immediately bring up this panel asking me who I'd like to share with. And it will find anyone in the immediate vicinity that has an Apple device. I'm gonna go ahead and wake up one of my spare phones here, and there's my spare phone allowing me to click on it, and it will immediately send all of those pictures to that user right into their phone quickly. And those are the best ways that you can share directly from the photo app. But they're not the only ways you can share from the photo app. So let's step into shared albums. There's a lot of ways to create a shared album, and you can do it by clicking the plus button next to shared albums, but that's just not the best way to do it. The best way to do it is to come into your library first, select whatever pictures you want to have shared, and then click on the share icon. From here, you're going to choose shared album, and you're going to get an option to share it to an existing shared album, like the ones that we see here, or to create a new shared album, which is what I'm going to do here. You give your album a name, and then here you get the option to invite anyone you want into this album. Here's a MacWhisperer Pro power tip for you whenever you're sharing things to another Apple user. Don't use their email address. And the reason why is because most people have multiple email addresses, and I don't always know which one is their Apple address. So if you send it to an email address that isn't their Apple ID, they're never gonna get it, and it's gonna cause all of these headaches. In some cases, people have so many email addresses, they don't even know what their Apple ID email is. The way to solve that is to send it directly to their phone number. By doing it directly to a phone number, you are going to ensure, as long as they have an iPhone, that it will connect properly to their Apple ID. So you can add any people you want to right here, and you can add a comment if you want, and when you're ready, you click Create. Now that shared album will show up under your other shared albums here on the left side. And the person who is invited to that shared album will see that invite under the activity section of the Photos app. And once they accept it, they become a part of this shared album forever. At any given point, you can take additional pictures and just drag them and add them right into that album, and they will get uploaded and everyone will get them. And even better than that, the other users can add their own photos in too. So when you're at a wedding or a family event, if you create that shared album, everyone can put their own pictures there. Once you've created a shared album, you can add additional people to it or remove people from it or edit it by coming up here to the people icon. Clicking on that will open up a panel which will show you who the owner of the shared album is and whoever's a part of that shared album. Here we see a question mark because my wife has not accepted that invitation yet. I can always click here and resend the invitation if I want to, or remove the subscriber at will. I can also come up to the top and add an additional person in right there so that it's easy. You've got a couple of options here. This one allows the other subscribers to post their pictures in. You want to have that on for those family events unless you don't want anyone mucking with your perfect shared album. Down here, you're gonna see notifications if other subscribers add pictures or comment or like the photos. And here, this public website section, if you click it, it's going to give you a specific website link that you can share with anyone, whether they're on Android, PC, or Apple, where they can view the pictures. Over time, you'll find that there becomes way too many shared albums, and a lot of them are just unnecessary. So make sure you clean those up whenever possible. And that's shared albums. Now in just a moment, I'm gonna drop a super powerful pro tip called shared photo libraries, which is gonna change the way you and your family share pictures forever. But before I do that, if you got value and learned something new out of this video, give it a thumbs up. That helps other people find this video easily and quickly. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, take a moment, hit that subscribe button and that notify bell so that you are always notified whenever I drop new content. And with that being said, let's get into that power tip. One of the challenges that I've seen for years between husbands and wives is managing all the pictures you take separately of the same events. If only there was a way for us to have a separate library that was for the family, and all of the pictures that existed for my family members automatically went to that library on their own. And then I could have my private pictures, but I could also have this family library where it's easy for me to see all the pictures that everyone in the family took of the family. Apple finally released that tool. It's called Shared Photo Libraries, and it's super easy to use. The first thing to do is come over to the Photos menu up at the top here, click on it, and go into Settings. In your Settings section, you're gonna see a new tab called Shared Library. Right down here, it's gonna ask you to get started. Here, you get the opportunity to add participants. You can have up to 5 people that share this library. So at the very least, you and your spouse, or maybe you and the kids. I'm gonna add this later, and you can always add additional people at a later point. In the next screen, you're going to get an option of adding your existing pictures into this new shared library. And there's a couple of different ways you can do it. You can click on the top, which will take every picture and add it. If you've been married for 30 years and all your pictures are family pictures, this is a really easy way to do that. Or you can come here and choose by people or date. You can choose specific people that you want to see pictures of. Certainly me and my wife, maybe my son and my daughter, and click add. You can always add additional people at a later time. Then you click the next button. And then you get an option to choose what day you want to take pictures from. Now in my case, I've only known my wife for a couple of years, so it's easier for me to come in here and specifically pick the first day we met. I don't really need her to have pictures from before our relationship. So that makes it easier to grab that selected chunk of pictures that have been taken after we met and go ahead and click the next button. You'll get an option here to preview your shared library to make sure you've got what you want in there and to make any changes before fully committing to it. But I don't want to do that because that's going to take too long for this video. I'm going to go back all the way to this screen and I'm going to choose manually. Choosing manually means I can pick whatever pictures I want to share and I can be very targeted and selected with it. Remember, we can always add additional pictures or remove pictures later. I'm going to go ahead and click the next button here. It brings up my library and I can select a couple of pictures that I want to add to it and I can click the add button. And now my shared library is ready. Up at the top, you've got this new drop-down menu. Right now it says both libraries. But if I click on it and I choose shared library, these are the four pictures that are in my shared library. And if I choose personal library, these are the pictures that are in my personal library that aren't a part of that share. And if I choose both libraries, I'll see everything all at once. And the most important part when you're on both libraries, if you look over here, you're going to notice a little badge of two people in the upper right corner. That means that picture are part of the shared library. It's easy to add additional pictures to the shared library simply by pointing and right-clicking on any picture and clicking Move One Photo to the shared library, and immediately, now that's a part of the shared library. Or if I don't want a picture there, I can right click again and I can say move one photo to my personal library. I now have two separate libraries, my personal library with whatever pictures I want, and they can be private and they can be separate and they can be work related, and my shared library for all the things I want to have with my wife and my son and my daughter so we can all see each other's pictures easily. So those are the best ways I know how to share photos and videos on a Mac. Did I miss something? Drop down into the comments section and let me know what you learned and what other ways of sharing I might not have thought about. My name's Dylan Stewart. They call me the Mac Whisperer. And it's my passion and profession to help you get more done with your Apple products than you ever thought possible. And with that being said, I'll see you next time.